Good morning, dear students. So today we are going to start with the workbook practice questions from the chapter, that is shapes. Now, students, in the last class we have discussed some of the questions which are from the workbook itself. Now, after that there are a few questions left, and after that I have come to practice question. I have left some of the question in between, and those questions are actually from the tessellation, or you can say tiling. Student, actually, since we are having online classes, we have to be more concentrated on the core content. Core content means which are the most important concept of the chapter, which is going to help you in the upcoming classes or the higher classes. Those topics we have to concentrate little bit more. So that is why the topics which are little bit less important, those topics we will little bit skip, and after that we will go ahead with the main core content. Fine, student. So, students, that is why I have left some of the questions, and whenever we will come back as a revision, suppose we have completed all the syllabus and after that we have time, then we can definitely come back and we'll go ahead with all these discussions again. Fine, students. So, let us start with the practice question. Please be ready with your workbook and student with the copy, because in practice question, you are not going to write in the workbook because there is no space given. You have to use your copy to write. So, please, students, write down the details like chapter name, shapes, workbook, practice question, today's date. Fine. Now, the first question, if you have the chapter, workbook with you, see the first question, that is number one. That is, name the center, radii, diameter, chords, and semicircle in the given circle. So, in the question number one, students, if you see, there is a circle drawn. In the circle, you can see the picture like this, and something like this, and the names are given, say R, T, then S, Q, then there is a point Q, and finally there is a center, this is O, and then pin P. Now here they are asking to name the center. Now the center is O. Then what is the radii? If you see, radii means it will be more than one, so that's why they are not saying radius, they are saying radii. Now how many radius we can see? O R O Q O P. So we can write O R O Q and O P. Fine, student. So these are the radii, you can say, of the circle. Then there is diameter. So how many diameter we can say? How many diameter you can say? There is only one diameter, and that diameter is R Q. R Q. Then after that, what is there? Chords. So how many chords are there? If you see the chords, students, we can see RQ will be a chord, because since it's a diameter, but diameters are actually chords only, the longest chord. So RQ and ST. That is, one more chord is there, that is the ST. And then semicircles. So there are two semicircles, students. We can see semicircles. So if you say semicircles, you can say semicircles, how many are there? When a diameter is drawn, it divides it into two parts, two semicircles. So one part is this one, another part is this one. So we can say the semicircle as R U Q. So that is R U Q. We can draw like this. That's a curved part. And next one is R P Q. That is the next one. This part. So there are two semicircles, students, in this particular you can say picture or the image. Fine. So that is the question number one. Now question number 2, it is given, number 2, shown at a pizza of diameter 50 cm, what is its radius? Now you need to find out the radius. Now students, diameter is given, I am writing diameter means D, I have percentage, and D is equal to how much? 50 cm. So what will be its radius? Radius means R, R stands for radius. So what will be the radius of this? Now students, when diameter is given, if we need to find out radius, we have to do what? We have to do divide. That means the diameter divided by 2. Now diameter is how much? 50. From 50 divided by 2, and that will be how much? 25 centimeter. That means the radius of the pizza is how much? It is 25 centimeter. Fine, student. So that is question number 2. Now let us come for the question number 3. Question number 3, it is written, if the radius of a circle is 6 cm, what is its diameter? Now radius is given. Radius is given how much? 6 cm. And we need to find out what? Its diameter. Now students, radius is given, then diameter is equal to, we know, it is 2 into radius. because it is twice, double. So 2 into radius means you can say 2 into 6, and that will be how much? 12 centimeter. The next one, if you say number 4, number 4 is again coming and draw a tessellation using the shape. Now students, I am telling you this tessellation topic we are not going to discuss now for the time being, because that's not a core content that I am, if I have to say. So that's why we will leave this question for the time being. I will not give you as a homework also. So we will discuss it later on whenever we will come back for a revision. Now let us come for number 5, is it again about a tessellation. We will go directly to number 6. Now question number 6, if you see, is the core content. If the radius of a plate is 7 cm, what is its diameter? Now students, the radius is given how much? It is given 7 cm. And we need to find out the diameter. Now we know that when radius is given, then if we need to find out diameter, what we have to do? The same thing, 2 into radius, that is 2 into 7, and it will be how much? 14 cm. Fine, 2 sevens are 14. Now number 7. Now students, see this number 7. It's draw and name a circle of radius 2 cm. Now that I will not be able to draw here, because for that we will need a compass, the large compass, and that is at school. So students, this question number 7, that is draw, it will be your homework, because you have to draw the circle of radius 2 cm by yourself and using the compass. So I hope so you are now able to arrange the compass at this moment, because already you are getting the option to buy the things. So I think you can do it, so that number 7 will be your homework. I will write you down the homeworks, don't worry. Then question number 8, if you see student. Now student, see, I am rubbing these answers, but if you are not able to write at the time when you are watching this video, you can do one thing. You can go back, because you are watching this video on YouTube, so you can pause it also, you can go back also. So you go back and pause it wherever it is needed to write down the answers. Fine student. So next question now. Okay, now the next question is question number 8, because 7 is your homework. Number 8 is, if the diameter of a circle is 30 cm, what is its radius? Now diameter is given 30 cm, so what will be its radius? Now the students, radius, of course, if we need to find out the radius, what we have to do? We have to do that diameter divided by 2. Now diameter divided by 2 means 30 divided by 2, and that will be how much? 15 centimeter. That means the radius of the circle will be 15 centimeter. So that is question number 8. Question number 9. Now it's about the reflection and symmetry. Number 9, the letter W and its mirror image look the same. Find three English letters that look the same as their mirror images. Now see students, I'll just describe this question. You are going to find out by yourself. You will be able to see the letter W. Fine. Now if I put a mirror here in front of the letter W, now what will be, this is the object. Fine. And this, suppose this is the, you can say, image. This will be the image. Now so that how it will look like in the image. Now it will exactly look like the same. That means when we put a mirror in front of a letter W, it will exactly look the same. You can try it. You can, in a piece of paper, you can draw a W and you can see it in the front of a mirror. You see that it will look like the same. So students, you need to find out such three English letters. Fine. English letters which will have the same mirror image. That means it will look like the same in the mirror also. And you have to find it by yourself, and you cannot write W again, because W is the example given. So you have to find out from the rest of the English letters. Fine children. So this will be your homework again, that is question number 9. Now question number 10. Question number 10 is about line of symmetry. Now question number 10 says that, how many lines of symmetry can we draw through a square? Now students, say suppose this is a square. How many lines of symmetry we can draw? We can divide the square by vertically. We can divide the square by horizontally. And we can divide it by diagonally also. That means like in this way. So how many lines of symmetry we can get? We can get lines of symmetry here, 4. So question number 10, as it says, how many lines of symmetry can we draw through a square? Is the answer will be 4 lines of symmetry. Fine students, so that is question number 10. Now question number 11, name a cuboidal object that can tessellate. Again it's a question of tessellation, so skip this question for the time being, number 11. Number 12, can you draw a line of symmetry through the palm of your hand? Now students, if you say palm of your hand, if you say this is your palm, fine. And can you be able to draw a line of symmetry? If can you divide, sir, simply think, can you divide your hand into two equal parts? This palm, you can divide into equal part. Is it possible? Definitely not. Why? Because the fingers on the left and right will not be same. If you divide from vertically also and from horizontally also, it will not be same. So what will be the answer of this question? That is number 12. Can you draw a line of symmetry through the palm of your hand? So question number 12 will be no. And what is the reason? Because our palm or palm of the hand is not symmetrical object. It is asymmetrical. Fine. Okay, now question number 13. Draw the mirror image of 8. Now suppose students, 8 is written like this, and suppose this is the mirror I have kept in front of it. So how the mirror image will look like? It will exactly look like the same only. Fine. That means 8 will look like as an 8 also in the front of a mirror. You can try it by yourself. Draw an 8 on a piece of paper, keep it in front of a mirror, and you can see that how much it is, how it looks like. Fine. So it will look like the same like this. So you can draw this figure. Then there is two questions, that is 14 and 15 left. So let us go ahead this also. Question number 14, it is about again the radius. It says that the diameter of a cycle tire is 62 cm. Diameter, that is the diameter means D. So it is 62 cm. What is its radius? So of course it is the same question. So it will be diameter divided by 2 to find out the radius. So it will be 62 divided by 2. Now students, if you know how to divide, it's very easy. It's a simple division only. 62 you divide by 2, it will be 2 3s are 6. So it is 0. This 2 will come down, then 2 1s are 2. So again remainder is 0. So what is the answer we got? 31 centimeter is the answer we got. So that is number 14. Now number 15. Number 15 is again a little bit different question, students. It's about circle only. Number 15, it is, do concentric circles have different radii? Now what are concentric circles, students? Please understand that first. Suppose this is the center and I have drawn a circle first. Fine. Now this has a radius of this circle. Again I will take little bit longer radius and I will draw a new circle. But center is same. Again I have taken the same center and I have drawn one more circle like this. Now see this three circle. All these three circles have the same center or not? Definitely yes. This type of circles are known as concentric circles. Fine student, concentric. Now can you tell me that all these circles are equal size, of equal size? Definitely not. The inner one is smaller, outer one is little bit bigger, and the outermost is the greatest one or the biggest one. So their radius is also different. That means the smaller circle will have a smaller radius, second one will have little bit greater radius, and the third one, the outer one, will have the more radius, the highest radius. So the question says that do concentric circles have different radii? Yes, they have different radii. You can see this example and understand. This circle will have a different radius, this will have a different, and this will have a different. Then only we can say they are concentric. Fine. So that means we can say yes, they have different radii. So that is the question number 15. So students, this concludes the first chapter, if you say that the chapter shapes. So as I said students, that I have already discussed the practice questions. I have left some of the questions which are not exactly from the core content, so that's why I left them, because we have to go for the other topics also as of now. So we can say that today we have concluded this first chapter, that is shapes. From Monday onwards, we are going to start with the new topic, that is the new chapter, that is pattern. Fine. And I already said there are two questions left from here, which I will give you as a homework. So after the video, you will get the picture of the questions, what you have to do. Fine. So students, please go through these questions once again, the question and answers. And I told you that if you are not able to write down as of now, you just pause it, you go back, and after that you can write down the answers properly. Fine. And do the homework and send on the proper time. So in the next class, we will definitely start with the new chapter, that is pattern. Fine, students, till that time, do study well, take care of yourself. Thank you.